So it's early in the morning and me and Ryan have turned up to the customer's house. We're just outside waiting for them now. We're here today to fit some downlights, aren't we?
Yeah, 16 in total, isn't it?
16 Collingwood downlights. They're ones that I've never fitted before. And so I don't think they're new ones, but they're push fit ones.
Seem pretty easy, just push, slot in.
They look quite easy. So it's the first time Ryan's been with me. And it's also the first time Ryan's ever
done downlights.
So he's done lots of other things. So let's go into the house and see how it is. So then, this is the light that we're going to be fitting today, the H2 light. Okay, it's made by Collingwood. I've not fitted these ones before. So let's have a look and see what things we have. So one of the interesting things on this light, it's got this little switch here. Can you see the switch there? That means that we can operate the switch into three different positions, and it can go between like a cool white, a blue light and a warm light. So it's like a 3-in-1 function. So let's have a go at fitting it. So we'll take this off. Comes apart nice and easily. So as you can see, that's slightly different on these ones compared to some of the other downlights. They're just push fit fittings. And so, I don't know if you can see that, it's your line, your earth, your CPC goes in there, your neutral, and then it's your neutral, your CPC and your line in there. And they're just simple push fit fittings. Now hopefully they'll be as simple as just literally pushing it down with your thumb and pushing the cable in, or I'll have to push down with a screwdriver. I don't quite know yet. So we'll just do this first one. And so we've not done one of these before, so we'll just offer it up. Can you see that, okay? Mm-hmm. And so we want to cut it down to about an inch or so. So we'll see how this looks. Normally, if I was just doing a single light like this, I would be doubling back the actual conductors. But on this one, there's only enough room really to put it in on a single. So I'd normally double them back to put them in there, but we're not going to do it on this one. We're just going to push them straight in. So put a little bit of the earth sleeving on. Something like that. And it looks like it is literally as easy as just pushing all three conductors in. It's never that easy, but it might be. Let's have a go. So I'm just pushing them all of them in. It definitely isn't that easy. Let's just trim that back a bit. Like I said, this is the first time I've done these ones, so I suppose once I've done them a few times, that'd be okay. So I've got to try and push them that down, which opens up the little gate inside, and then they should all just push in, but let's try it again. It's gone in. And that looks just like that. And then if we've got another one, this is on the end of the circuit. I've chosen the easy one to do close up, but then we'll just need to put another one in side by side. So actually, it's actually quite nice. I think that should all be okay. Give it a wiggle. That's okay. We then just need to put the clamp on. And that just gives the cable a little bit of support, stops it from pulling out. Like so. And then this box just then clips on like that. And there you have it. So we get the light put back in the hole. Again, we have to be careful of these spring clips, because you want to make sure when you put them in there's no cables laying either side and that they go in nice and neat, just like that. The last downlight that we've fitted, and so you can see the connections there. So we've got the line, CPC and the neutral of one leg, and then it's the neutral, CPC and line on the other, and it does look quite neat. Right, got all four lights in, they're all on there now. We haven't put the bezels on yet, because now what we need to do, if you just look on this light, we've now got these switches here, so we just need to set the switches so they're all the same light. Preferably, I think we're going to go with the warm white option. So I'm just going to turn the power on. On as well, let's turn them on, and there they are, quite bright, aren't they?
Mm.
So just to show you what the switches do, so if we just operate the switches, so we've got the warm white, the cool white and the very blue light. So that's on his phone. We'll have them on the white light. Okay, the last thing to do is just put the white bezels on. Just turn them off because you can't see. And you're looking up. So again, they've just got two little clips and they clip in here and they just twist on. So they hold in and just easy as that.